All right, we're here with Mason Onati, a 2023 infielder from Olentangy Liberty High School. I want to welcome Mason on to the Bo Jackson League Commitment Spotlight. How you doing, Mason?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing well. Doing well. Good to chat and dive into what the last year or so has looked like for you with recruiting and definitely want to celebrate your commitment to Tulane University and hear all about how that came on the radar. So. Before we get into that, take us back to when you were younger. How early did you start playing baseball? And talk a little bit about your family.
So I started playing baseball when I was around 3 years old. My brother was 4 years older than me, and I played on his team. I was in a diaper. He was on T-ball. I was in a diaper, just running around the bases. It's just been a long ride with my whole family. My brother just moved out. He's up in Maine now, and so like everything that he's done, everything my mom and my dad have done, has been such a big help for me to get into the spot I am today, which I never would have thought I was would be in like by last year. So they've just been a big help, and I can't thank them enough for everything they've done for me.
So great. So did you play other sports growing up, or, when did baseball become kind of your thing?
So, yeah, I played basketball and football and baseball all growing up. I let go of basketball, I want to say, seventh grade year. Then football, I planned on playing last year, but it didn't go through. Just wanted to get better for baseball, lift for baseball and everything. I was going to play football this year, but I hurt my arm. So I was just like, you know what? I haven't got as many reps as I wanted to in the infield. So I decided to take that time off and go train and play fall ball and everything. So I think that's been a big help, is just playing all sports that you can growing up, becoming athletic, getting the IQ for every sport, and knowing how to be a teammate is just a big, big thing for, I think, every young player and every player in the world. Because if you're a bad teammate, nobody wants to be around you. So I think that's a big thing that I played three sports.
Yeah, no, that's a great perspective. Kind of, being a teammate transfers over to any sport and then transfers – beyond sports when your career is done and you're in the workforce, and so I think you're spot on with that for sure. Talk a little bit about, you mentioned the injury and navigating a few bumps in the road here the last few years, and describe a little bit just how have you kind of maintained your passion through being injured. It's not fun to be injured. Guys deal with it all the time, but talk us through kind of what that process was like.
So I think it's more, when you get injured, you have to be there for your team more than you can, like, feel bad for yourself. So if you go to a game and you're feeling bad for yourself, sitting in, like, an arm brace like I was, sitting on the bench and feeling bad, your team's not going to – I mean, if your team does something good, be up for them, be happy for them. Like, you're still a part of the team, and I think some people don't realize that. And they make it all about themselves and how they're hurt and how they can't wait till they come back. Like, yeah, I was excited to come back. But, I mean, like, I made the best memories when I was hurt with everybody on the bench. Like, talking about pitch sequences or talking about what we saw from the umpire, what we saw at that at bat. So it's still – it's always about, like, learning and figuring out everything that you can still do on the mental side, even though you're not in the physical game. So I think that played a big part. So,
yeah, that's some good perspective there. And it sounds like you took full advantage of, being in the dugout and learning the game, even though you were injured, not on the field. So really cool. So let's kind of switch gears a little bit to, you play at Olentangy Liberty High School. Obviously last year with COVID, it was a shortened year, or you guys weren't even able to get going. But talk a little bit about the culture there, and it's one of the best programs in Central Ohio, and definitely one of the best in the state of Ohio. And just talk a little bit about Liberty and your time there.
So from what I know is I was going to play right field, batting ninth, and that's something that I would have never thought I would be doing. I thought I was going to be playing shortstop. So it's just figuring out what you can do to help make the team win and help figure out what you want to do for your brothers. Like, because at Liberty, it's a family. I mean, the culture there is top notch. I mean, if you see somebody, doesn't matter what age you are, if you see a senior, if you see a sophomore, if you see a freshman, if you see a junior, and they're late, you have to hold them accountable. I don't care what grade you're in, you have to hold them accountable. So that's a big thing for us is accountability. And then just being there for everybody. I mean, like, they're your brothers. You're going to be with them for quite a while. And you can't be selfish. You have to be selfless. And you have to figure out how to help people while helping yourself. And if coaches aren't there, you have to figure out how to be your own best coach. So that's a big thing that Coach Branning preaches on us is figuring it out through the hard stuff and through the easy stuff. So that's been a big thing. And I mean, just being a family and having that competitive drive as a family is just, it brings your game to a whole nother level because you want to be there for your teammates rather than being there for yourself. So. Mm.
So, you know, I heard you mention a good deal about culture, and you definitely provided a good window there at Liberty and the culture there. We'll switch gears a little bit to, you know, your summer team, the Bo Jackson Elite 2023 team. You know, I've had a chance to talk with a lot of the guys on the team. Committed here lately, you know, I was able to get a kind of window into it a little bit in the summer through some Zoom calls and things like that, but it's pretty clear that team has a strong culture and a very connected culture. And just talk a little bit about that experience this last summer and you know, what it was like playing with those guys.
Yeah. Last year, it was probably the best summer I've ever had. Like, it doesn't matter about record. I mean, we could have gone 41-0 or we could have gone 0-41. But, like, I still love every single one of them. They're such a great group of guys. I love them. I couldn't thank them enough because, like, they pushed me to another level that I didn't think I could be at. And that's what helped me be committed by right now. So they helped me through that. They helped me through my injury. And they helped me, like, just become, like, a different man. They taught me about everything that some coaches have said to me, but, like, they proved it. Like, they showed that everybody has a significant role, no matter if that's batting ninth or if that's batting 11th. So they showed me a lot through the summer. And it's such a great group of guys that I couldn't thank them enough for everything they've done. So,
yeah, that's so great. So, you know, within the last few weeks, I think five guys, you know, from that team have committed all to play Division I. You know, you're talking Kentucky, Michigan, Tulane for yourself, Louisville, Purdue. So it's a highly competitive roster, but at the same time has maintained, you know, some sense of connectedness and culture. Talk to us a little bit, in your opinion, how have those two gone hand in hand? Highly competitive, but a connected culture. And you know, what do you think some of the key factors have been for your team to be able to create both this last summer?
So it's for sure been the we over me mentality. So it's like, if you're down by three and heading into the fifth, you want to just get the next guy up. You don't want to hit a home run and try to finish it all off by, like, in the fifth. I mean, you're not going to finish it in the fifth inning. So it's been that, and, like, being there for each other, picking them up, that's been a big thing. If somebody makes an error, we got you on the next one. We're there for you. So it's been being not afraid to make mistakes. I think that's what's proved everybody's competitiveness. So I think that's been a big thing, is just the way over me and like not being able to, like, if you make a mistake, yeah, we got you. We're there for you next pitch. So
awesome. So another unique aspect for you personally, for your summer team, the 2023 Bo Jackson Lead team, is that your dad's the head coach, super involved. And talk a little bit about, you know, has he been your coach your whole life, or, you know, how's that relationship gone on the diamond, and what's that been like?
So, yeah, he's been my coach my whole life. I don't remember really any time he hasn't been my coach. This fall is really the only time he hasn't been, like, in the dugout, but he's still, like, a coach. So he still, like, watches all ABs and hears everything that's going on in the dugout. But it's been a fun ride with him. I mean, it's a different perspective that you have to have as a coach's kid. And you have to realize, people are always going to say, oh, you're playing daddy ball and stuff. Like I've been told that since I was nine. Like, you're only starting at shortstop, batting first or third because it's daddy's ball. But it's just like, when you get home, you can talk about your at bats. You can talk about what went on in the game. You can talk about the lineup and everything. So I think that's been fun, and he's taught me so many life lessons through baseball, that if I played like soccer, I know he still would have been there for me. So it's just been a fun ride with him, and he's helped me through thick and thin. I mean, I can't thank him enough for everything he's done. So he's so good. I mean, I love him to death. I mean, even though we get off on the wrong foot sometimes, we always, like, figure it out the next day. Sometimes we need a break because, like, I'm with him every second. So,
so what do you think, you know, because there's a lot of guys in your shoes throughout the, you know, amateur baseball space. And what would be some advice you'd give to some other coaches' sons, you know, out there that are navigating what you've gone through with having a dad as a coach, and comes with a lot of pressure, you know, like, yeah, you mentioned, it comes with an awareness of what maybe other people are thinking about your role or your performance, or, you know, if you could talk to other coaches' sons, you know, what would be some pieces of advice you'd give?
Yeah. I would probably, the biggest thing is probably take every lesson that you hear from him, take it to the next level and try to have a conversation with him about everything that you can. I mean, the conversations are what drives the relationship. I mean, on the field, like, off the field, he's going to be your dad, but on the field, he's your coach. So you, like, the personal relationship you have with him is going to be different than any other kids, because you've known him for your whole life. So I think it's just learning, taking the lessons to the next level and taking your knowledge to the next level, your IQ, and knowing what's going on around you and having the awareness about what's going on around you and having the awareness of what's going on, like, within you. So you have to be able to have both of those going at the same time. So I think that's the biggest thing I could tell the people that are in my shoes that are younger than me and older than me. So
it's great. Yeah, it's good stuff for sure. Let's switch gears a little bit to the dome. You know, I think you and your dad have taken advantage of the facility about as much as anyone I've seen in our organization. You know, throughout the summer, on, you know, Thursdays or Fridays, it's live at bat days at the facility, and a lot of college guys flock in, and we've had some pro arms throwing, and I can recall about midway through the summer or towards the end of the summer when the season was over, all of a sudden, you know, a sophomore, Mason Anani, is stepping in the box against AAA arms and talk about that experience and just how much the dome has assisted in your development process.
I mean, it's been such a big thing ever since I transferred over to here, to Bo Jackson, in what, 13U, I think. It's made such a big difference, taking my game to the next level, being able to practice every day. Because, I mean, you're inside. It doesn't matter what the weather is outside. So that's been a big help. And then the lifting aspect has been a huge help. Like, I gained 20 pounds in the last year. So that's been a big thing, is just gaining weight and lifting and getting stronger and getting competition that you have, like, that's older than you, is probably the biggest thing that's helped me. It's driving me to be better and to show up every day and know what you're doing every day. Having a plan of what you're doing every day is probably a big thing too. So Dome has been a big help, me getting in there, trying to get in there. So yeah, that's been a big help for basically since I was 13.
It's great, and you're reaping the benefits, and imagine how much more in the next 2-3 years with your work ethic, where things are going to go. So that's outstanding. So let's switch gears a little bit to kind of the recruiting process. And, you know, at what point this summer did Tulane emerge as an option, and how did that kind of come about?
So they talked to me when we were down in Lake Point. So that was like, I want to say mid-August. So they started reaching out to me, and then we had a call, and it lasted about an hour. So that was probably the longest call I've had. And I felt so comfortable with Coach Ullman. And then the next day I called Coach Jewett. So both of them, I just felt so comfortable. They felt like stepdads to me. I mean, so, and then we had a call after they offered, I want to say, they offered about a month later after we've just been calling, like, week to week. And we had a FaceTime. And then the very next day, we had a FaceTime with all the coaches and my parents. So that was a big thing for me, is just realizing that they have big interest in me and realizing they know what they're doing. So that was a big thing, is being comfortable and having my parents comfortable and having my whole family comfortable with me going down to Louisiana, which is like 3,000 miles away. So, I mean, that's a big thing, because my mom, she always talks about housing and stuff. So she wants me to be comfortable. She wants me to be happy. So that was probably a big thing, was just the comfortability with all the coaches and the place down there. So,
yeah. You know, talking a little bit about Travis Jewett, is one of the, you know, biggest hitting and offensive minds in college baseball at any level. And, you know, what all excites you about playing for him? And you know, he's got experience at a lot of the top programs. He's a, you know, associate head coach and hitting coach at Vanderbilt, and worked with some dudes, you know. And, you know, what excites you most about kind of his philosophies and the way he structures offensive stuff?
Yeah. So probably like the new drills that I'm going to figure out, the new culture. I mean, I'm excited about the culture. I'm excited about the family. We've been talking to a bunch of other Tulane commits. I mean, like Bryce Amos at a Shadyside High School. I played fall ball with him, and he's already like a brother to me. I love that kid. So I'm excited about to like meet my new family. And with Coach Jewett, I'm excited just to like get out there and be a part of his team and just figure out new drills and figure out new everything. So that's gonna be fun. And I'm just excited just to get down there. So
were you looking, you know, to go out of state from the get-go? You know, the South is a big deal when it comes to ball. Was that always on your radar, or, you know, was it not? Were you trying to stay local, or how did that develop?
So it was always on my mind, but I didn't think I could play there till I gained the weight and stuff. So I was more thinking local, like Miami, Ohio offered. I was leaning towards them, and then Tulane came in and offered, and I was just like, oh, okay, this is going to be different. The AAC is the third best conference in the nation. So it was just getting out of my comfort zone and knowing that I have to develop into a man. Like there's going to be some dudes down there. So to be able to get to see the field and everything is going to be fun. Hopefully if I can develop strength, develop everything.
That's an awesome perspective for sure. So kind of let's switch gears a little bit and you know, this whole recruiting process, can you highlight a moment or two that it was the hardest, you know, what was the hardest part? You know, was it comparing other people's timelines? Was it navigating injuries? And describe just kind of what was the toughest part of this whole process for you?
So I think the toughest part in this process for me was probably how fast everything sped up. From the first offer to the commitment, it just went like that. I mean, I didn't, like last year at this time, I did not think I would be committed by now. I thought I would be committed by junior, senior year. But the process sped up so fast. And I mean, I'm thankful for it. Like, it was different. It was fun. I mean, like some people hate the recruiting process, but like I loved it because, I mean, you always have that on your mind. It gives you something to have on your mind. Like, where do I want to go to college? Like I and it's the respect that they have for you too, for offering you. Like, they expect you to play at the next level. And they expect you to like be good. So I think that's a big thing, is having, like, knowing that you're good and getting that sense that, oh, I can do this. So that was probably a big thing.
No, that's a phenomenal perspective for sure. What, you know, have you thought about majors? And, you know, Tulane's a definitely a high profile academic institution. And talk to us a little bit about just kind of what your perspective is on all that.
So that's one thing you have to research when you're calling and having all that in the recruiting process. That's probably one big thing, is researching majors, researching the coaches' bios and stuff and everything. So I think that's a big thing. And I'm planning on doing something, following my dad's footsteps and something in the medical field, but like not going to medical school, because that's going to take too much time and stuff. So I think, yeah, it's something for sure you have to research while you're calling people and figuring out the money situation within every single college. So yeah, that's a big thing, is doing your research.
Yeah, that's great stuff for sure. That's cool to hear the medical field. You know, I've had friends over the years whose parents have been in the medical field, and I think it goes two directions for their children. Either they say, I'm all about this, or I want nothing to do with this. So that's cool. Yeah. Well, let's kind of wrap things up and just talk to us a little bit. You know, if you were to sit down with a room of 12, 13-year-olds, and what kind of advice would you give for someone who's beginning this process for recruiting? You mentioned it went just like that, and it was fast. But, you know, if you could go back and do it over again, or help someone else prevent from having some mistakes in the process, what advice would you give?
For sure, have your own timeline. Don't go based off their timeline. Don't make them rush you. If they rush you, it might not be the right fit, but it also could be the right fit. I mean, it's also good to have a timeline. Makes you speed up your thought process on everything. So that's probably a big thing. And also, have fun with it. I mean, if you don't have fun with it, I mean, baseball is going to get boring. Baseball is not going to be fun anymore. So having fun and having that competitive drive throughout your whole life is a big thing, whether that's whatever sport you play, whether that's baseball, whether that's football, or whether that's like ice hockey or something. So that's probably a big thing. Just have fun. So
awesome. That's a phenomenal advice, man. And thank you so much for jumping on here with us. And we're so happy.
Thank you for having me.
Commitment to Tulane, and certainly equally excited about all the progress you'll make from this day to graduation or move-in day. So some good stuff in front of you, and we're pumped, man. So we'll
thank you.
See you soon.
Yep.
See you, man.